Hello again. We're really pushing on now. I can see the end of the rust repairs in sight. This was probably the worst bit on the car when I've looked at the car. There was multiple pieces that were quite rotten. I mean, this is rotten, but that should be a lot easier to repair than the sill bit. It's funny, some of the repairs haven't looked too bad, but yeah, the more you dig into them, the worse they get. The wheel well doesn't seem too bad, just a couple of patches to put on that. Yeah, basically most of it's pretty sound. That's me, I've just put some more primer on it, so any bits that were alright I primed up, so left the bits that needed work. It just shows that more of it is finished. It's a bit more, sort of gives you a bit more enthusiasm to get carried on. I'm really looking forward to once this is done so I can start putting the roll cage in. I think that'll be, you know, welding, it'll be cleaning up, but it'll be clean metal. There's no more cutting of this old stuff out. It's amazing how much stuff I'm cutting out of it and how bad it is. The rear part, I haven't really, I've started cutting it out, but that's not what this video is about. Yeah, this is the outer sill, and that's like a strengthening piece inside, the bit, and it was rotten at the bottom where it meets the support for the rear beam. Yeah, you could see the rust that got to it. So I'm just cleaning it up, taking out the spot welds, so I can take out what is left of the rotten piece. And fortunately, most of the piece that was remaining was in good condition. I cleaned it up and it get all the rust out of it, and it still had strength in it, and it was sticking up. So I had to take part of it out, and then I had to take a bit more of the outer sill out because there was still a bit of rot where I'd cut it. Yeah, so this was cleaning it up, getting it ready. I was making a piece to go on the inner bit. I think it's welded on there, but I didn't really show that very well. This was the easiest way of making a piece for here. Just welding in as it is, and then cutting it down once you can line everything up. There is a gap on the other side between the rear quarter and that piece I just put in, so I had to build that up as well. Yeah, they're the bits that join the strengthening bit to bit together at the bottom, just miss those. Yeah, that firmed it all up. You can see where the rear beam mount is, that's all been made up as well. Yeah, this, I just welded it all on. It was a bit hard to get to it because, you know, that's the ceiling, it is quite high now. I thought it'd be a lot easier getting to it. I need to, so I've just sort of tacked it in, and I'll do it when the car comes down. This is a profile I'd left over from the front part of the sill piece. So I'm just making a longer bit that I can weld in. This was folding the bottom over as it is on the original car. I don't know if they fold it over just to give it a bit of strength. So I just did the same. That's where it gets jacked up from. So that's quite possibly why. Just basically putting in a vise. I've used a couple of bits of steel to make so I can get longer bits in it. Otherwise, it just gets a bit tricky trying to bend it over. Yeah, it's quite straightforward to do, and that's the piece there. I need to put a bit extra on the end, but you know, it's a lot easier doing it in pieces rather than trying to do it all in one piece. This was me drilling holes in it just so I could plug weld it, and then I primed the back of it with weld through primer. So welding it on now. Just, you know, you could do it all in one piece, but it's going to be quite a big piece to get into the vise. And this, on the normal kits, the fiberglass kit I've got, normally people cut all this off and don't have anything there, and they just use the fiberglass, which, you know, I really don't want to do. So I'm trying to get some strength back into it by cutting the rot out and putting new fresh steel in and welding it onto weldable areas clean of rust. So I could scribe a piece in. Oh, hang on. This is me panicking now that I might not have enough room to put the fiberglass panel on afterwards once I've finished the welding. So because it might have moved slightly and be in the wrong place, I did cut the bits off a long time ago, so I just wanted to check that it would fit all right, and it did. I've been watching a video from a video on YouTube, and it's Dave's Garage, the YouTuber is, and it's very interesting. He's restoring a Mark 1 Escort, and he cuts everything with a jigsaw, so I thought I'll give it a go, and it's so much more pleasant than using an angle grinder. And I can't believe how many angle grinder blades I've gone through, so I'm... And it's a lot easier to see where you're going with the jigsaw, and you can cut like different angles, and you don't overcut it like you do with the angle grinder. This was a piece I just cut to go on top of the parts I just welded in. That was welding the final piece in that I hadn't welded in before, of the lower part. Just cleaning up a bit. This is all getting covered with a fiberglass sill. So I'm not fussed what it looks like, as long as it's got strength in it and it's no rust in it. So I just lap jointed it. I didn't bother butt jointing it because it would have taken twice as long. Lap joint it, then just tied it up. I didn't even go mad cleaning up the welds on it. It's not going to be seen. That would be removed from the other, you take it from above that, but this won't be seen. So coat primer, then later on I put a bit of seam sealer on it. That's the seam sealer. The seam sealer I use, it's actually Painter's Mate. It's about £2 a tube, and it's great stuff. I use it at work a lot. It's flexible, so if there's any movement, it's not going to crack. It seals all the holes, and it just will stop any moisture from getting stuck in the weld bits or the seams. It seals it up, just pleasant to use as well. So I tend to just put loads on, especially in areas like this that aren't seen. Pile it on with the silicon gun, and then with my gloves on I can just rub it in, really. Or you can use a brush and brush it in, but the brush tends to be wrecked afterwards. The paint wasn't fully dry, but it doesn't matter, it still works all right. And I sometimes like putting, because what I'll do is I'll prime it, then I'll put the seam sealer over it, push that in, then I'll prime it again over the seam sealer. So I like to prime it again before the seam sealer's gone off. I didn't do it this time because I left it too long, so it was a bit, it had hardened up by the time I primed over it. But if you prime over it when it's still wet, you sort of push it in with the brush. If you don't do it straight away, you don't pick it up on the brush as well. You can push it around. It just makes it a bit look a bit nicer. It's good when you're getting to the seam seal a bit, because it means you'll get to the end of that area. And all the car's been done in sections, so this was another part. And once this is done, which is pretty much now, I've got the rear quarter, which you can see just to my left. Not the rear quarter, it's like the rear valance, which shouldn't be a difficult repair. And there's a bit on the wheel well, a couple of bits to put in there. Excuse me. There I am, concentrating deeply. How to push it in. You just smear it around, and you can see where it hasn't gone, so you can just push a bit more in. You do have to throw the glove away and put another one on. So I usually do it last thing that I'm doing, or just give the glove a wipe, use the put the primer on it, and then use the glove to put the brush from the primer in it. I've been doing this for a few weeks now, and I'm still using the same primer brush. I'm not into cleaning brushes. I'd rather throw them away and get a new one. It's just lazy of me. But if I had a pot with brushes in it, I'd just knock it over and you'd get water or whatever everywhere. So I push the glove into one of the finger sockets. I push the brush, into one of the finger sockets on the glove, and it keeps it moist, so it's ready to go again. So it comes out a funny shape, but once you've done a couple of brushes with it, it's all works fine again. Yeah, this is just finishing off pushing the seam sealer into where it needs to go. inspecting my handiwork. Yeah, and it's just, I'm so pleased we're getting to the end of it. I'm just getting sick of the rust and the mess it makes. And wearing the overalls is a big bonus, because before, especially grinding, even grinding the new stuff down, you get covered in it and you just bring it into the house. I can't, I have to get everything off as soon as I come through the door, otherwise it just leaves a mess everywhere. Yeah, so that was primed over the undersill. That lip I might have to clean up a bit and cut back. But I'll touch it up once I get the car back at a normal angle rather than sitting on its edge. You know, that's not the prettiest repair, but, you know, it's good for what I need. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully it won't be long and I'll get the rear valance bit done, and we're not far off the end of the rust repairs then.